We have been assigned some cases. These psychopaths must be found. The other agents couldn't get them. But I can do it.
Thank you.
things which are burned into my memory. My name is Thomas Foster, and my duty is to bring these four psychopaths to justice. I just hope to resist their sadistic influences. Their corrupted minds could overpower my own. I will find them. I must. Jake Gibbs, London, England, 1962. Professor of History. Suspected for the kidnapping of 17 people, disappeared in the adjoining areas of a cabin owned by his family. The missing persons have in common certain indirect factors, religions or pagan practices, foreign nationality, that are not reason enough for the local police to start an investigation. Doorways. Link the profiles of the victims to the topics in which Professor Gibbs specializes. Crossroads. I knew I had to keep going and follow his steps if I wanted to find the professor. But I found something about the place absolutely terrifying. I felt trapped, oppressed by those dark veils, and I knew that I wouldn't be able to stand a single minute lost in the darkness. I need to find a light source as soon as possible. Felt I was retracing the steps of many others like me. How did they overcome the mortal chill that lurks in the darkness? Their souls went astray and got lost forever in the shadows. Because there was another horror that scared them even more, that made them flee into the dark woods. They fled the place I'm entering. people were tortured in this timeless place. What is this castle doing here? I could swear that there were no buildings or ruins like this in these woods. Many of the victims were prisoners of war, but some are much more recent. Of those I can see, I can look through their eyes. All of them are males. Prisoners, yes. But there were no wars being fought when they were caught. They were kidnapped, one by one, and brought here by the Professor. Might he see himself as a righteous man? An emissary of God? At that moment, I remember wondering, is all of this just my imagination? Perhaps now I should add, or is it a figment of the broken memory of this maniac? remember having felt great relief when I left behind those sinister dungeons with their dark halls and their whispers. The presence of those accusing, tortured souls was killing me at every step. I didn't do this! Once in the clearing, the tranquility of having found an exit was interrupted by the sudden notion of my finding me once again in the dark woods. Those haunting shadows were starting to drive me insane. Still, something kept me moving forward. I knew I was closer than ever to the place I needed to find. I was determined to discover the truth. Whoever was responsible would pay for the suffering he'd caused. Hundreds of times before, but I'm sure this is my first time here. Until yesterday, the existence of this hideout was mere conjecture. The applied engineering on these torture machines is astounding. What type of mind is that brilliant and at the same time that twisted? that it can design systems so efficient in dealing pain and affliction, having to go through the function of every piece of the machines is torture itself. I can feel the despair of the victims while the professor methodically assembles each part, making them watch, making them imagine the pain before provoking it. But I must do it. I have to follow every step in his memories as accurately as possible, because that's the only way to feel what he feels, to see what he sees, and then find him. Not only physically, but spiritually as well. This is the price I have to pay to get him and make him pay for his crimes. wish I could forget about all those horrible places. I'd rather have them as my own memories, and not this mix of feelings. My mental privacy has been compromised, and at the same time, I feel guilty as someone who regrets having stolen something precious from its rightful owner. Which was the fate of the professor? What kind of punishment would make him pay for the suffering and the deaths of his countless victims?